everyone, Shawn here, and today we're going to go down memory lane a little bit with Savannah, and I'm going to show you how we came about getting all the ingredients together for her to get now into the top 7 in the world of long drive. So we're talking about a girl who grew up around a golf pro, but who played soccer and did her dancing and her figure skating and all that stuff. And then soccer really took a nice foothold, and golf was just nice to see dad, you know, maybe a half dozen times a year on the driving range. And until we got to high school, and then we started to get a little more serious because it was her second sport, it was her fall sport, and she needed to get on a very strong team. There were 3 full scholarships on that team, and there were 6 spots available. So she really had to work her butt off to make that team. So we did, and the thing about it is, at the time, we noticed that this was when it was really popular to coil upper body against lower body. So the other girls in the team, they had very, very still legs, and they were trying to coil upper body and try to, you know, get their power that way. And they were 40 to 50 yards behind Sav. And what I taught her, first and foremost, is to get rid of all the resistance in her swing. And then we noticed that, of course, as a lefty, she hit a lot of shots to the left. So we made the grip as strong as it needed to be, which is what you see today, a very, very strong grip. And then she got used to that grip, and that's what gave her all that power, because we gave her everything she needed to get to the target. So first and foremost, and this is what you're seeing the trend on tour now, is getting rid of the resistance in the backswing. So we're allowing the whole rib cage and pelvis to turn completely out of the way in the backswing, and that lead knee is coming in behind the ball. So if we look at, you know, how we create width, and, you know, just about every player on tour back in the 60s and 70s swung that way. Hale Irwin, 45 wins that was just beat out by Bernard Langer. Jack Nicklaus, Arnold Palmer, you name it. So if I'm going to take my arm and I want my arm to swing past me toward the wall, if I don't move my body, all I'm getting is a pec full of bicep. So my arm has no access over there. In order for it to have width over there, meaning if I'm going to have some width towards you, I have to turn. So my arm is coming straight towards you. I'm getting really terrific width. The only way I can get that is through turn. So I'm getting natural, relaxed width without effort by simply letting my body turn completely. And in actual fact, the legs are assisting me in getting into my backswing. So if I were to take a club upside down, hold it like a sword, imagine I had a bamboo shoot here. I'm going to turn my whole backside behind that bamboo shoot, and I'm getting ready to use the weight of my arm sword unit to release through. So that was the beginning, and you'll see some excerpts here as I'm going along of Sav when she was of that tender high school age, right? So I'm going to make my grip nice and strong. You'll see that with amazing players on tour like Ryan Moore, who's doing really well right now at the Barbasol, had one of his best ball striking rounds on Thursday, shot a 64 and left a boatload on the table. So super strong grip, which is what allows us to get to the target. And we're going to get completely out of the way in the backswing. You hear that compression? And what you're going to see here is I had to move my mat to the side there, and I'm back to playing blades. This 7-iron is the loft of last year's 8-iron for me, and there it is at 179 carry. So, do you hear that crushed compression? That was simply bliss on a stick. especially when you nut it in the center of a club face with an iron. So that's number one. We remove the obstacles, and now that we have this beautiful momentum to deliver to the target with, never toward the ball, the only way you get to the target is with a grip club relationship that's strong enough. What you don't, you know, many of you who are looking at this for the first time and getting their first taste of wisdom in golf right now, if I do neutral grip square face and then my hands come through first at impact, look how open that face is. If I close the face 30 degrees, and you're thinking, that's nuts. You've actually gone off your rocker, Shawn, right? But then the hands come through first. Not so crazy now, is it? So it may look very closed here. Backswing, then the right arm folds, the wrists hinge. I'm going to the target. First thing the brain's gonna do is go to the ground. Use the ground to get my body out of the way. Notice my hands get through first. That's how you get lag. Now I can collect the ball from here, and the ball's gonna come off the face here, nice and square, in the direction of my target. It's leaping off the club face right about here, and then the release and the peak speed is out there. So in essence, what we're doing is we're collecting the ball from here and releasing it out there. Just with those two items, add 30 yards to your shots. So Sav is already 30 to 50 yards farther than the majority of the girls, all the girls on her team. And then she takes another break because now she's playing university soccer. She's super serious. And, you know, you understand what university coaches and all that stuff's all about. So she felt she left a lot on the table there. And she says, well, Dad, I want to be great at something. So I want to get back into golf. And of course, she's got all that potential for distance. So we got her back in and we polished the swing. We polished what we just talked about. And we had 100 miles an hour club head speed with carries of 260, which is 40 yards more than the average LPGA Tour player back in 2018. The stats came out with TrackMan, 219 yards was the average carry for an LPGA Tour player. So we're going, hey, this is great. So we're coming in with, you know, mid to short irons instead of hybrids and fairway woods. And then we went at it and we tried to do the best scoring that we could. And then COVID hit. And then long drive was the only thing going still in COVID. So Munashe, which bless his heart, after 2 years of playing, I look at his potential. I'm thinking, oh my God, this guy's a perfect candidate for long drive competitions. We got him in here. We got him in there last year, and he started making a couple of top 16s and missing by very small margins, and he's getting it out there 400 yards, just a few yards off the top guys in the world. So he made it into the top 50 the first year, and Sav says, well, I want to travel with him. And then I said, well, if you're going to travel, you're going to compete. And she goes, okay, well, we want more reps under pressure. We don't have any tournaments right now in COVID. And she fell in love with long drive. So the two of them are in long drive right now. And then we got her going deeper. So here was the next step. One of our training tools that we use a lot here at the Academy to get people to really feel the G-forces in the swings, our swing caddy. It's this beautiful little unit. It's got a magnetic head here. And then when you give it a swing, there's a little click that occurs. So we crank it up there, and we had our standard unit is at 110 miles an hour, and it's pretty true to form. So she was clicking it at about 100 miles an hour, and she was getting a little ticked off, and she's getting a little stagnating, and then she starts swinging, and all of a sudden, oh, we got a click. This one's the pro model at 135, and I'm able to click it at that setting, but I really have to give it a whirl, and I would never swing that way on the golf course, but in long drive I would. So all of a sudden, the legs appear, and I've been trying to get her, hey, let those legs go, and because she was tentative and she was playing a lot of golf and she was being too careful, the legs were stagnating, and then when we started really opening things up, the legs started to move properly. So a good way for you to learn how to use your legs, let me get my hammer here. So if we get just a 4-pound hammer, and I wanted to heave the four-pound hammer out there, you'd notice I would use my legs to do that. Heave. Now, if both hands are on the hammer and I wanted to heave it out there, notice how my legs are being used right now? This is being taught universally on the PGA Tour for players to get more power. I've been teaching it since 2007 on YouTube. If you go to one of my oldies but goodies, you'll see Create Serious Speed, Shawn, Clement. And you hear me talking about this up and down. So at the time, this was absolute voodoo. It's like, oh my God, Shawn, your head's moving up and down. Are you nuts? Your contact's gonna suffer. Well, if you look at how we function as human beings, my center of gravity's here, I wanna take a walk. I have to fall forward and catch myself. I just came down. Then the swing of my arms helps me come back up. So when you see somebody walking, you see bobbing up and down. You don't see this. This is not a proper walk. That's a workout for the legs, okay? So if I'm walking and swinging, send the grass. Notice I'm not moving side to side. Very, very nice laterally, but my head's moving up and down. And notice I'm constantly cutting the grass. I'm getting a proper level there. There we go. So I'm gonna cut the grass. Send the grass. The machine is getting the wrong readings right there because it's catching my club head swinging. But that last one there was absolutely nutted. And we're looking at an easy 180 yards. So we're never trying to stay level. We're not thinking about going up and down with the legs. That would be crazy. We're using the weight of the arm club unit to throw the club in the direction that we want to start the ball. And now when we throw the club and we don't let go, this is when we develop those G-forces. So I'm gonna throw it and not let go. Do you hear that nice click? That's where I'm really feeling those G-forces pulling on. That's a beautiful little shaft that you have in there, and it's very heavy on the end. So you really feel that you can give it a whirl. Now when you take that and pretend you got that magnetic chamber at the end of the club and you give it the same whirl, then you're really getting a very, very cool, that was a little thin, 170. So you do pay a little bit more of a price hitting it thin with a blade, but 170 yard blade, 7-iron, we're still in great shape. So now we have the up and down. We're not trying to do it, but we're using that up and down motion to turbocharge the swing of the arms. So now we take that and then we add the lifting of the heel. And the crowning glory was, don't try to keep this heel down. When you turn your back to the target, don't try to keep that lead heel down. Allow it to come up. So even though it's coming up, when I take this club and I'm gonna throw it to the target, well, the first thing my brain needs to do is go to the ground. Use the ground to get my body out of the way. So now I've got full turn, full squat, then I have rotational momentum to get me out of the way. And that gives me just a boatload of power. So if we take the driver now, and the driver I've actually gained a few yards. So my ribs just finally healed. Now, the key to this one is I'm going to take the tip of that tee and I'm going to make the tee somersault in the air in the direction that I want the ball to go. So I'm going to do that completely unrestricted, and I'm going to use the G forces in my swing. So it's, see that beautiful range of motion there? So what I'm trying to do is send the tip of the tee tumbling in the air over that intermediate point right there, and I'm going to use momentum to do that. Here we go. Almost. That felt pretty good. And I mishit that. So nice power fade. Notice my side spin on that was only 252. Let's try one more for you. We'll do it with more ease. Oh, baby, look at that. I went easier, 50 side spin left. And we're looking at 294 carry, 325 total. One more for the road. Oh, that's perfect flight right there. Little closer to the toe. Wow. Not bad for a 57-year-old who just is getting over some rib injuries, and I can feel that my body needs to work out right now, so we're gonna go ahead and do that. I mean, look at the side spin, 33. So I've got that Ventus Black TR. It's a 6S. I've got the Aerojet 9-degree from Cobra. It's on standard loft. And 15 degrees launch. The ball speed's at 161. And my total distance on that last one was 320. My peak height was 126. I mean, an absolute dream. So, the people you want to consult to get yourself going with this, Munashe Masawi, Moo, the great Canadian Sasquatch. So you go to wisdomandmovement.com, and that's the abbreviated way. Take a look in the description. It'll be right there for you. Enlist with his speed training program. It is exactly what we teach, but he has a very specific structure and how to get that done for you. We've got some brilliant drills for you to use to get the job done. And you will see improvements within the first week, guaranteed, okay? So get with Moo, really enjoy that. For all the rest of the information that you're going to see there, go to wisdomandgolfpremium.com, and for $10 a month, $9.95 a month, you get access to my life's work. All of the things that we've discussed today are in there, plus, 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 okay? And if you want to do some one-on-one with me, you get to do that as well. You'll see it in wisdomandgolfpremium.com. Check lessons with Shawn, and we'll see you soon. All the best.